Yeah, so in this attention of cross-dry networks, the third type of cross-dry network is when the drainage and canal intersect each other. Drainage and canal intersect each other at the same level. So in previous cases, the drainage and canal at different levels. Either drainage is below the canal or canal below the drainage. Two cases we have seen. But here, if they are crossing at the same level, drainage and canal, if they are crossing at the same level. So the type of structures constructed are, I'll show you here. First one is level crossing, and the next one is inlet and outlet. First one is level crossing, and second one is inlet and outlet. So type 3 drainage, in type 3 cross drainage works, drainage and canal intersect each other at the same level. The first one is level crossing, when the bed level of the canal and the stream are approximately at the same level, and the quality of water in the canal and stream not much differ. The cross-dry network constructed is called level crossing. But the water of the canal and stream is allowed to mix. With the help of regulators, both the canal and stream, water is dropped through the canal and stream is required quantity. The level crossing consists of the following components. First one is a crest wall, stream regulator, and a canal regulator. So these are the, so the thing is, in the canal and stream are crossing at the same level, in that situation, the quality of water in the canal and stream is not much differ. Approximately the same quality of water is there in the canal and natural stream. In that situation, we will going to construct level crossing. In this level crossing, so we need to control the water flow in the canal as well as the stream by constructing the regulators, canal regulator and head regulator. Canal head regulator and stream head regulator need to construct, and a crust wall to the canal has need to be constructed. Okay, we'll see the component parts of level crossing. So level crossing, every one constructs the one. In the canal and drainage are crossing at the same level, and the water quality of water in the canal and drain are not much differ. In that situation, we will prefer the level crossing. Okay, so we need to control the water flow in the canal as well as the stream by regulating regulators, head regulators, or flow regulator, cross regulator we're going to call it. So cross regulators arrange for the stream as well as the canal. And one crest wall need to be constructed for the canal, the drainage water not to allow into the, for that purpose we're going to construct crest wall for the canal. We'll see the sketch also. I'll show you the sketch here. So this is a level crossing. So this is the river. So river flow is in this direction and the canal is flowing in this direction. So for the regulating of canal flow, here one canal regulator will be there. So it will, we can regulate the flow in the canal by providing regulating head cross regulator to the canal. Similarly, we need to construct one regulator to the river flow also. This is called river regulator, river cross regulator. River cross regulator we need to, so here regulator is nothing but one gate, a shutter. Here also one shutter we're going to construct. For the river, one crest wall need to be constructed. So crest wall another construction. river. So this is the canal flow and this stream flow. And the canal water stream like all kunda some height to manage some anate up to some height we're going to construct the wall here. Anyhow, this shutter will going to close here. The downstream side, upstream side, one crest wall will going to construct. After that, water will move like this. Crest wall construct here and kundi. The canal water is easily move to the river water. So river under the eppudu continuous undadu only for a season. For a season, river will flow, but depending upon the requirement, canal has to flow. Even in the summer season also, even in rainy season also, depending upon the situation. So this level crossing also helpful for if heavy floods vachinappudu, some of the water, heavy floods vachinappudu endante canal gates would open chestarandi. Canal gates would open chesinappudu automatically some portion of water will enter into the canal. So this is can with this we can avoid the submergence of the surrounding areas. Submergence of surrounding areas we can control. So this type of structure is helpful for the submergence of surrounding areas. So this is the level crossing. When the level crossing is used, when structures are used, when the canal and stream are approximately crossing at the same level, and the quality of water in the stream and the canal is not much differ, in that situation we're going to construct level crossing. Okay, so now we'll move to the another one. It is type 3 cross drainage, that is inlet and outlet sections. So we'll see. So in inlet and outlet, when the irrigation canal meets this smaller stream, when the irrigation canal meet a smaller stream or a drain at same level, drain is allowed to enter into the canal at inlet at some distance from the inlet point. A part of water is allowed to the drain as outlet. Which eventually meets the original stream. Stone pitching is required at the inlet and outlet, and the beds and the banks between the inlet and outlet are also protected by stone pitching. This type of cross drainage work, CDW is nothing but cross drainage work, is called inlet and outlet. So inlet and outlet are constructed when small stream. So this is important. Small stream or a drain or a nala, when they are crossing the canal. So to avoid the construction cost, what they are going to do is the drainage is connected to the canal at one point, and after some distance, after the drainage water flow into the canal, after some distance, this drainage water will allow to go from this, and they will meet to the another stream. Stream and river la kalustha kada chinna streams kalisi oka pedda river avutundi. So river la kalisetappudu they will allow like this. So they will construct a structure here. So this is called outlet, and this will be the inlet. This will be the inlet, and this will be the outlet. Okay, so but stone pitching is protected. It is protected. Inlet and outlet is protected with stone pitching. Inlet portion and outlet portion. It is also for the same portion. That is, this stretch also is protected with the stone pitching. So this is nothing but inlet and outlet cross drainage works. Type 3. This is comes under type 3 cross drainage works. I want to show you this cross drainage figure also. So this is the inlet and outlet. So this is the canal. You can see this is the canal. Small stream here entered here and leaving here. Okay. So there is entered here, and they are there, that is leaving here. So this is the inlet and outlet. So with this we can avoid the construction cost. So mana stream ki malli canal ki malli construction separate gaakunda. So with this same amount of same cost we can even construct canal and stream ki rendu kalisi okate manam structure ni construct chestuntam anamata. So that is inlet and outlet portion. I hope you understood about this. Next one is selection of type of cross drainage work. So which type of cross drainage work we need to select? So we have three different types of cross drainage works. We have type 1, type 2, type 3 cross drainage works. So how to select the type of cross drainage work? Selection of type of cross drainage work. So we'll see. Selection of type of cross drainage works, it is depends upon first thing is type of cross drainage works, it depends upon relative bed levels of the drainage and canal. So first one is it is depends upon selection of type of cross drainage works, it depends upon relative bed levels of the canal and drainage and the full supply level and high flood level of the canal and drainage. Next, second type of availability of suitable foundation for the cross drainage work. Availability of suitable foundation for the cross drainage work. Next one, economical consideration. Economical consideration. And the next one is discharge of the drainage. Discharge of the drainage. And the next one is construction problem. So these are the selection of type of cross drainage work. Whether we just go for the aqueduct or siphon aqueduct. Super passage or siphon super passage or inlet and outlet or level crossing, which type of cross drainage work we need to use. So it is depends upon the following factors. First one is relative bed levels of the drainage and the canal. Next one is availability of suitable foundation. The foundation is good, then we may go for the aqueduct. Depending upon the level difference, or we can go for super passage. Economical consideration. If it is not that important a stream, or it is a small stream is meeting the canal, so then we may go for inlet or outlet, or we may go for the level crossing, or we may go for different structure. So depending upon the economical consideration, also we may select the type of cross drainage. Next, discharge of the drainage. The discharge from the drainage is small amount of discharge is coming, or for the season the discharge is coming. Only for the season is discharge is coming. So depending upon the discharge, we're going to select the type of cross drainage works. Next, construction problems. So availability of road for this section is not there. The road availability ledandi. Next, suitable materials. Then construction suitable materials. Then daggarlo levu. Or any other heritage structures are submerging because of construction of this or labor problems. So if there is any problem is there, depending upon that problem, we need to consider those problems also for the selection of type of cross drainage work. Okay, these are the factors which are helpful for the selection of type of cross drainage works. So major important is relative bed level and availability of foundation. These are the technical details. Technically we need to consider these two. After that, these are the economical consideration, and this is also technical consideration, and this is the social consideration, the construction problems. Okay, so these are the factors that we need to factors helpful for the selection of type of cross drainage work. So I'll show you in detail about this one. So relative bed level, so if you want you can take a screenshot of this one. This is not there in our curriculum, even though I'm explaining this, so it may helpful for you, but take a screenshot of this one. Otherwise, I'm just recording the session. You can go through this. Availability of suitable foundation. Next, economical condition and the discharge and the drainage construction problems. Okay, so this is about the unit 5. So what the course content is available for the unit 5. This is the course content. This is not there actually. Okay, so this is unit 5. I'm just, if you have any doubts, you can ask me, students. Just stop recording. Just stopping the recording.